a poem by Walter Dean Myers. They took the road and way across Georgia, skipped over the tracks in East St. Louis, took the bus from Holly Springs, hitched a ride from Gee's Bend, took the long way through Memphis, the third deck down from Trinidad, a wrench apart from Gord Island to a place called Harlem. Harlem was a promise of a better life, of a place where a man didn't have to know his place simply because he was black. They brought a call, a song, first heard in the villages of Ghani, Mali, and Senegal. Calls and songs and shouts, heavy-hearted tambourine rhythms, loosed in the heart of city, like a scream torn from the throat of an ancient clarinet. A new sound, ruckus and sassy, cascading over the asphalt village, breaking against the black sky over 125th Street, announcing hallelujah, rifling past resolution. Yellow, tan, brown, black, red, green, gray, bright colors loud enough to be heard, light on asphalt trees. Sun yellow shirts on burnt umber bodies, demanding to be heard, seen, sending out warriors. From streets known to be mourning, still as a lone radio tells us how Jack Johnson, Joe Louis, Sugar Ray is doing with our hopes. We hope, we pray, our black skins reflecting the face of God in storefront temples, Jive and Jehovah artists lay out the human canvas, the mood indigo. A chorus of summer herbs, of mangoes and barbecue, of perfumed sisters, hip strutting past fried fish joints on Lenox Street in Stevie August. A carnival's children, people in the daytime streams, ring alivio warriors, stick ball heroes, hide and seek knights and ladies, waiting to sing their own sweet songs, living out their own slam dunk dreams, listening for the coming of the blues. A weary blues that links the new and county song, a river of blues where Du Bois waited and Baldwin preached. There is little tempo cadence, a language of darkness, darkness known, darkness sharpened at midsongs. Darkness lightened at the cotton club, sent flying from a Ephesian Baptist church to the Apollo. The uptown, eight rattles past 110th Street, unreal thrill, relaxing the soul. Shango and Jesus, Ashante and Mende, one people, 100 different people, huddled masses in crowded dreams. Squares, blocks, bricks, fat brown women in a rectangle Sunday night gospel. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. Caught by a full lip, full hip sync, watching collard greens and a crack for plain sync, backing up Lady Day on the radio. Brothers so black and blue, patting a wide foot outside the too hot walk-up board. You ought to find the guys who told you you could play some checkers because he didn't lie to you. Crack three in soprano sax laughter floats over a fleet of funeral cars. In Harlem, sparrows sit on fire escapes outside rent parties to learn the tunes. In Harlem, the wind doesn't blow past malls. It stops to listen to the sounds. Serious business, a poem, rapacity, tripping along Strivers Row, not getting its metric field soiled on the well-swept walks, hustling through the hard rain at 2 o'clock in the morning to its next gig. A huddle of horns and a tinkle of glass, a note, handed down from Marcus to Malcolm, to a brother, too bad and too cool to give his name. Sometimes despair makes the stoop shudder. Sometimes these are endless depths of pain, singing a cappella on street corners, and sometimes not. Sometimes it is the artist looking into the mirror, painting a portrait of his own heart. Place, sound, celebration, memories of feeling, of place, a journey up on the A train that decided to dance in Nigeria and has not come here.
published in 1925, a collection of fiction, poetry, and essays on African and African-American art and literature. The New Negro is considered the definitive text of Harlem Renaissance, along with W.e.b. Du Bois. Locke was a leading philosopher of the Harlem Renaissance and gave the movement direction and inspiration.
Social activist, novelist, playwright, and communalist from Missouri. He is the most famous person associated with the Harlem Renaissance and among the most influential leaders of the movement. Throughout his poetry, novels, plays, essays, and children's books, he promoted equality, commended racism and injustice, and celebrated African American culture, humor, and spirituality.
Was an American jazz musician and singer, songwriter with a career spanning nearly 30 years. Billie Holiday was one of the most influential jazz singers of all time, not because of the quality of her voice, but her willingness to go beyond the regular jazz set. Notably, the song Strange Fruit was first recorded in 1932.
Silent trees.
Hurston arrived in New York City in 1925 when the Harlem Renaissance was at its peak, and soon she became a prominent figure of the movement. She was the most prominent female writer of the Harlem Renaissance, and her 1937 novel, Their Eyes Were Watching God, is considered among the most influential works of not only the Renaissance, but also of African American and women's literature.
Duke Ellington is considered the heartbeat of the Harlem Renaissance, and Duke Ellington's contribution to the genre was phenomenal. He moved to Harlem in the mid-1920s and became one of the early innovators of orchestral jazz. His orchestra, which he led from 1923 until his death, is the most famous orchestral unit in the history of jazz. Duke Ellington wrote more than 1,000 compositions, making him one of the most prolific composers of jazz ever.
W.E.B. Du Bois, in 1909, Du Bois co-founded the National Association for Investment of Colored People, NAACP, in 1910. The NAACP launched its official magazine, The Crisis of Du Bois, as its editors for the first 24 years. The Crisis played an important role in the Harlem Renaissance, providing a platform for several well-known writers of the movement.
So, you may be down in history with your bitter, twisted eyes. Shabby in the very dirt, but still like dust, arise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you blessed with gloom? Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns with the certainty of tides. Just like hope springing high, still arise. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head in my eyes. Shoulders falling down like teardrops, weeping by sorrowful cries. Does my heartness offend you? Don't take it off my heart. Cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I'll rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise? That I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs. Out of the huts of history's shame, I'll rise. Up from the past that's roots in pain, I'll rise. I'm a black ocean, leaping and wide, welling and swelling out there in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I'll rise. Into a daybreak that's a wondrously clear, I'll rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I'll rise, I'll rise, I'll rise.
what God has made me as. Yet I'm never ashamed, just in pain, just outraged at what the world is today. My friends can't play like the others, barely being one another, each other. The white man never put himself in our shoes, played by our roles. It doesn't take a Christian to believe in my spoken truth. Raising my fist brings an undeniable power to my youth. And remember, truth sounds like hate to those who hate the truth. The fact we're still fighting should be a clear clue. You don't really know racism until you witness it too. Show me where in American history where all lives have mattered, Sandra Bland. Maybe one day they'll all understand. Okay. Think of the government as a leech. Goes great for whites but messes up color. Signing off on imprisonment, taking sons from their mothers. Locking up innocent men, destroying any bond between one another. A sister shouldn't fear when the cops stop her little brother. She should remain calm and trust in Officer Southerns, right? See, this is where we're lost in translation. This is where a said cop may abuse his occupation. You can't erase scars with a bandage. Maybe one day they'll all understand it. Joanna Lucas, thank you. Come on.
Arrived from Geese Bend, took the long way through Memphis, the third deck down from Trinidad, a wrench apart from Gort Island to a place called Harlem. Harlem was a promise of a better life, of a place where a man didn't have to know his place simply because he was black. They brought a call, a song, first heard in the villages of Ghani, Mali, and Senegal. Calls and songs and shouts, heavy-hearted tambourine rhythms, loosed in the heart of city, like a scream torn from the throat of an ancient clarinet. A new sound, ruckus and sassy, cascading over the asphalt village, breaking against the black sky over 125th Street, announcing hallelujah, rifling past resolution. Yellow, tan, brown, black, red, green, gray, bright colors loud enough to be heard, light on asphalt trees, sun yellow shirts on burnt umber bodies, demanding to be heard, seen, sending out warriors. From streets known to be mourning, still as a lone radio tells us how Jack Johnson, Joe Louis, Sugar Ray is doing with our hopes. We hope, we pray, our black skins reflecting the face of God in storefront temples, Jive and Jehovah artists lay out the human canvas, the mood indigo. A chorus of summer herbs, of mangoes and barbecue, of perfumed sisters, hip strutting past fried fish joints on Lenox Street in steamy August. A carnival of children, people in the daytime streams, ring alivio warriors, thick blonde heroes, hide and seek knights and ladies, waiting to sing their own sweet songs, living out their own slam dunk dreams, listening for the coming of the blues. A weary blues that links the new and county song, a river of blues where Du Bois waited and Baldwin preached. There is little tempo cadence, a language of darkness, darkness known, darkness sharpened at midsongs. Darkness lightened at the cotton club, sent flying from Ephesian Baptist Church to the Apollo. The uptown, eight rattles past 110th Street, unreal thrill, relaxing the soul. Shango and Jesus, Ashante and Mende, one people, 100 different people, huddled masses in crowded dreams. Squares, blocks, bricks, fat brown women in a rectangle Sunday night gospel. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. Caught by a full lip, full hip sync, watching collard greens and a cracked proclaim sing, backing up Lady Day on the radio. Brothers so black and blue, patting a wide foot outside the too hot walk-up board. You ought to find the guy who told you you could play some checkers because he didn't lie to you. Cat Green in soprano sax laughter floats over a fleet of funeral cars. In Harlem, sparrows sit on fire escapes outside rent parties to learn the tunes. In Harlem, the wind doesn't blow past malls. It stops to listen to the sounds. Serious business, a poem, rapacity, tripping along, striver's row, not getting its metric feel soiled on the well-swept blocks.
Was a waitress, so I can't help but tip over H. The lane that she working double shifts, no trips. But it ain't the same, you and me ain't get in trouble. I get 10 million more money, not a yip juice. I get 50 racks in the club to a pill juice. I blew 2 mil on my dog for a pill juice. Shows me that I can buy a race, strip my street cred.